Probando esta guitarra, es una Epiphone que modifiqué hace un tiempo, con este Superfuzz Univox y con esto de aquí atrás, que es un cabinet Marshall de cuatro bocinas de 12, Vintage Story, y el Randall este de los 70, Commander 2. This is a Epiphone guitar. It's a junior, I believe. Oh, no, a special Epiphone special model. Yes, and I modified this guitar like this. I mean, actually, my dad gave me this guitar like in the year 2000, I guess. And it's a pretty cool guitar. Yesterday, I was cleaning my stuff here, so I found this one, and I say, oh, let me test this one. This is very. I have the tone very low. It's like I think it's, this is. I don't know, but it's something I don't remember, but it's very low. But listen to this. Pickup, let's hear the neck pickup. Vamos a escuchar el, esto fue con el del puente, ahora escuchemos el del neck, a ver qué tal. Esto así, por si acaso quieres saber. This is my setting with this pedal. So let's check it out. The different mode right here, and the same, the knobs will be the same. So let's hear this. Vamos a probar esto de la otra forma con la opción de este pedal. A ver. Esto con lo que es el neck. Now let's try this one with the neck humbucker. Let's hear this. Smashing Pumpkins sound, bien Smashing Pumpkins el sonido, Yo no sé ustedes, pero bueno, vamos a probar esto un poquito más así, dejarlo a la mitad exactamente. Como que tiene un sonido bastante, al probarlo de la otra forma, el switch, it has very, very nice tone with, you know, the different way, the switch, you know, in different position, so it sounds like with more rich, the range, like a mid-range, very, very rich, so let's hear it. This one, I think this thing, okay, let me try this, let's see what is the difference here, because it's pretty confused sometimes, these controls, son bien confusos estos controles, porque son como, uno se llama expander y el otro se llama balance. Realmente no tengo como muy seguro qué es eso, pero vamos a probarlo por ustedes. Let's try this for all of you guys, because it is really confused for me, and I guess for many people, these things, or more, you know, because this is a pretty old pedal, so old-fashioned style, so one of this one says expander, and the next one is balance. So here's the tone, you know, the tone control. But the thing is, like, sometimes it's a little confused what means this, what is the function of this, and what is the function of this one. So let's try a little by little, let's hear what is that. Okay. Half. So it both sounds like a volume pedal. Quiet now, because I don't want the police here. Anyway, just quick. Okay, let's try this one and the other function, or the next function. Servido de algo este video para poder tener una idea más clara sobre cómo funciona este pedal, o por lo menos cómo suena. Voy a hablar un poquito rapidito sobre esta guitarra. Para los que mucho me han preguntado sobre esta, porque había hecho un video, a ver, uy. Había hecho un video sobre esta guitarra hace ya un tiempo. Esta guitarra mi papá me la regaló ya por el año 2000. Yo la modifiqué. Let me speak a little bit about this guitar, because long times ago I made a video talking about this guitar, and this is a very cheap guitar and sounds pretty cool, and I just modified this one with this this sticker, but a really nice sticker, so it's something like very good material. It's practically something like a little metal there, and that those kind of stickers, you know, that are pretty nice quality. I found it on eBay, and I changed the pickups. These are general pickups, are not like any famous brand, so I just add this one. I installed the pick guard, a very like a Les Paul Junior, you know, the vintage one. And I changed the knobs for these school knobs, our BC Rich brand, and practically I changed everything. The sticker is still here because this sticker is old. I have it for when I was playing with my old band Plasma in early 2000s, 2001, 2, 3, until 4, 2004, I believe. Todo esto lo modifiqué, le cambié las calcomanías estas, los pickups son unos pickups generales, no son de ninguna marca. El pickguard se lo instalé, es un pickup barato, todo esto lo encontré barato esto en eBay. Igual los knobs estos son como de calaverita, pues aquí está, son unos BC Rich, estos knobs son de metal, y bueno, y cambié también let me show you a better way. Like this, I think it's better. Okay, these are school knobs as well. Esto le cambié también los knobs, the tuner. These are the school tuners. Very nice. And estos son así de calaveritas también que encontré. And I just upgrade all this guitar because my dad gave me this guitar a long time ago. So the thing is, when I moved to United States long years ago, like 15 years ago, I leave this guitar in my country. So I leave it there, and everything was like, you know, rusty and didn't work some part. This was the jack was like
crack and sounds like I all need to clean or change it for a different one. So I told my dad when he came for visit to me, I say, bring me the guitar and I want to, you know, I just want a, like a project to fix it, you know. So now it's here. I mean, this I fixed this guitar by myself a long times ago, practically 2013 or 14. So I practically badly use it because I just have it for good memories with, you know, from my parents. Well, somebody have music there outside. Así que eso es, la remodelé toda porque estaba toda oxidada, no funcionaba lo que era el jack, el switch estaba malo y le di un giro completo. Esta guitarra es una guitarra barata, esta la puedes encontrar hasta por $100, pero yo no, yo la modifiqué así y bueno. Y aquí pues estamos con este amplificador que ya hemos hablado sobre este amplificador, pero por si acaso alguien está viendo este video por primera vez, voy a enseñarlo rapidito. I speak already about this amplifier and all this gear, but if for any reason, I don't know, somebody is watching for first time my channel or this video, so you know, I can tell you, you can find all about this stuff, you know, all these guitars in my YouTube channel. You can go into my playlist and find information about all this stuff, all this gear. Y estamos con esto, sí. Bueno, espero les haya gustado este video. Un día bastante caliente por acá en New Jersey y no tenía pensado ni hacer este video. Simplemente me puse a estar tocando y dije, yo voy a hacer un poco de ruido y bueno, aquí estoy haciendo este video. Así que pórtense bien, que nada les cuesta, díganle no a las drogas y nos vemos hasta la próxima aquí en tu canal. Este es uno de mis pedales favoritos. This is one of my favorite pedals, definitely. And see you next time. Follow me my you know, social medias, and there in the, down below I leave you some in the description of this video. I leave you some links there. You can check my other videos and check my original music. Also remember, I leave you there the link for my new single "Lonely." You can hear it. It's very, like, I don't know, something very cool and brand new music I'm making now. And in September, remember, in September 2020, I will release my third album, so check it out there. You can hear me everywhere, you know, Spotify, Apple Music, YouTube Music, and Google, whatever, Tidal, Deezer, and whatever place you want to hear me. My music is available in all those places. So, okay, así que pórtense bien, que nada les cuesta, díganle no a las drogas. Y recuerden, por ahí, síganme en mis redes sociales. Ahí abajito en la descripción de este video voy a dejar información de cómo poder encontrar en mis redes sociales y poder escuchar mi música original también, porque ahí abajito les dejo información de cómo poder ir a esos lugares. Así que pórtense bien, que nada les cuesta, díganle no a las drogas. Y nos vemos hasta la próxima aquí en tu canal con Oscar Stalin. Adiós, joder.